it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to do some half-up styles. I haven't done half-ups in a while, so I picked three of my favorites. Let me know in the comments which one you like the best. If you're new to my channel, as always, be sure to click that notification bell. Then you'll be notified whenever I post a new video, so you'll never miss one. And let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to part my hair near the middle. Then I'm going to pick up a small section of hair on the left side of the part to begin the first braid. I'm going to divide the section into three smaller pieces and cross the two side strands over the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the back strand over the middle and picking up a new section, bringing it into the braid. Now I'm going to drop down the front piece, pick up a new section of hair from behind the drop piece, and I'm going to cross this over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. So again, I'm crossing the back strand over the middle strand, picking up a new section of hair from the top of my head, and crossing it over into the middle strand. Then I'm dropping down the front strand, picking up a new section of hair, and crossing it over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. And I'm going to repeat these steps, bringing in hair to the top side of the braid, while dropping down the front section and bringing in new pieces into the braid in its place. And this is what will create the waterfall effect. I'm going to continue this pattern, working my way down the side of my head, and then curving the braid around the back of my head. And once the braid reaches the back of my head, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections into the braid and slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps as before. I'm going to pick up a small section of hair next to the part to begin the braid, and I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side strands. Then I'm crossing the back strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm going to drop down the front piece, pick up a new section of hair from behind the dropped piece, cross it over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. So again, I'm crossing the back strand over the middle strand, picking up a new section of hair from the top of my head, and crossing it over into the middle strand. Then I'm dropping down the front strand, picking up a new section of hair from underneath it, and crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. And I'm going to repeat those steps, bringing in hair to the top side of the braid, while dropping down the front section and bringing new pieces into the braid in its place. And I'm going to continue this pattern, working my way down the side of my head, and then curve the braid around the back of my head. And once both braids are done, what I'm going to do is take the right braid and slide it through the middle of the left braid, and then hold both braids against the back of my head, and then I'm going to pin them in place with bobby pins. So I'm just taking some pins and I'm sliding them into the braid horizontally along the back of my head, and then I can remove any extra bobby pins and unravel the ends of the braids. For the second hairstyle, I'm going to create two French braids on both sides of my head. So for this style, I'm going to begin by parting my hair on the right side in a deep side part. I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the left side of the part and divide it into three smaller pieces to begin the first braid. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and then I'm crossing the back strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the front strand over the middle, picking up a section of hair and crossing it into the braid as well. And I'm going to be adding in larger sections to create a puffier style braid. So I'm going to continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand while picking up new sections and bringing them into the braid as well. And once I've brought in hair along my forehead and the braid reaches my temple, I'm going to stop adding in hair to the back side of the braid and only incorporate hair into the front side. This will switch the braid to a lace style braid and make it look a little more formal and less rigid. I'm going to continue the braid, working my way down the left side of my head, bringing in new sections of hair until it reaches the top of my ear. And then I'm going to continue the braid without bringing in any additional hair and just continue the braid down towards the ends. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so that it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat those steps and create a second French braid on the right side of my head. I'm going to pick up a section of hair next to the part and divide it into three smaller pieces to begin the braid. And I'm crossing the side strands once over the middle, alternating between the left and the right side strands. Then I'm crossing the back strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the front strand over the middle, picking up a section of hair and crossing it into the braid as well. I'm going to continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand while picking up new sections and bringing them into the braid as well. And once I've brought in a couple sections of hair to the back side of the braid, I'm going to stop adding in hair to this side and only incorporate hair into the front side of the braid, bringing in new sections until it reaches the top of my ear. Then I'm going to continue the braid without adding in any additional pieces and continue the braid down towards the ends. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now that both braids are done, I'm going to bring the right braid around the back of my head and pin it in place at the center of the back of my head. Then I'm going to carefully go back over the braid and pull on the edges to try and make the braid a little wider so it looks bigger. Then I'm going to take the left braid and bring it around to the back of my head. And where it meets the right braid, I'm going to tuck the braid under itself and then secure it in place with a bobby pin. I like to slide my bobby pins along the length of the braid so they're hidden underneath the hair and don't show. Then I can go back over the sides of the braid and just gently pull on the edges to make it look wider and fuller. For the third hairstyle, I'm going to be creating two Dutch style fishtail braids on both sides of my head. And I'm going to begin by picking up a section of hair on the left side of my head near the part. I like to begin my fishtail braids like a regular braid, so I'm splitting the section into three pieces. Then I'm going to combine the middle and back strand together so I have two sections. Now I'm going to divide off a small piece from the back strand, cross it under to the front strand, and then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head and cross it under to the front strand as well. Then I'm crossing a small section from the front strand under to the back, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under to the back strand as well. And I'm going to repeat those steps, crossing small sections under to the opposite side while also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. But once I've brought in about two sections to the front side of the braid and two to three sections to the back, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and just continue the fishtail braid down to the end. So I'm dividing off small sections from one side and crossing them under, adding it into the opposite side. And I'm simply alternating between the left and the right side strands. And I'm just repeating these steps all the way down the section until the braid reaches near the bottom. And then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to go back over the braid and make it wider. So I'm going to carefully pull on the sides of the braid so it slowly slides out of the bobby pin. And I'm working my way up the braid, pulling out each section on both sides until the braid is as wide and as full as I'd like. And now I'm going to repeat those same steps and create a second fishtail braid on the right side of my head, just like I did before. I'm picking up a section of hair near the part, splitting it into three pieces, and crossing each side strand once under the middle strand. Then I'm combining the middle and the back strand together so I have two sections. And I'm going to divide off a small piece from the back strand and cross it under to the front. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair and cross it under to the front strand as well. Then I'm crossing a small piece from the front strand under to the back, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under to the back strand as well. And I'm going to repeat these steps, crossing small sections under to the opposite side while also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. Once I've brought in about 2 sections to the front and 2 to 3 sections to the back, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and just continue the fishtail braid down to the ends. This will just help make the braid lay a little bit more smoothly against the head instead of bringing in a lot of pieces along the entire length of the braid. And I'm repeating these steps all the way down the section of hair until the braid reaches the bottom. And then I'm going to take a bobby pin and slide it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And once both braids are done, I'm going to pin them at the back of my head. So I'm bringing the right braid around the back of my head and I'm going to wrap it under itself and then pin it at the center of the back of my head using bobby pins. And then I'm going to take the left braid, bring it around the back of my head as well, wrap it under itself, and then secure it in place with more bobby pins. And again, I like to slide the bobby pins into the braid, catching a little bit of hair and then pushing them underneath the braid so they stay hidden. And then I can remove any extra bobby pins and unravel the bottom of the braids. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of the 3 hairstyles was your favorite. The French braid was definitely mine. I've just always loved that style. Be sure to like and subscribe. Click that notification bell in case you haven't already, then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.